It seems like today, the more things you can do at once, the better.
I'm watching Netflix while eating sushi and writing emails. Multitasking.
But research keeps telling us that most people can't perform two or more attention-demanding tasks at the same time without doing one of those tasks badly. And instead of truly multitasking, we often just switch between two or more tasks rapidly, which is known as task switching. Research suggests there's a switch cost. People tend to slow down when moving from one task to another due to the time it takes the brain to realign to the new task. Scientists and the media also point to anecdotal evidence. If we're walking, we slow down when we look at our phones. If we're driving, we turn down the radio when we're looking for our turn. And if we're typing an email, we often lose track of what we're saying on the phone. It's often claimed that we can't multitask unless the actions or processes are so automatic to us that they don't require any thought, like tying a shoelace while talking about the weather. Unless, that is, you're a supertasker. They're people who can actually multitask. They can perform tasks at the same time and do them well. Take Lauren Moore, who holds the record for the fastest time to say the first 100 digits of pi while twisting a Rubik's Cube and balancing 15 books on her head. On YouTube, she just goes by Books on My Head. Or David Babcock's record for knitting the longest scarf while running. They're pros at doing somewhat odd things simultaneously. Supertaskers seem to have the perfect mix of attention, memory, and concentration. And in a 2010 study, researchers found that 2.5% of their participants were supertaskers. On a larger scale, that could be quite a lot of people, or quite a lot of you. The dual task NBAC is a task some studies have used to measure supertasking ability, and I want you guys to try it. In the task, you have to keep track of the changing positions of a blue square, and at the same time, listen to a stream of letters played over headphones.
S.
Then you have to indicate when the square's position matches the position it was in three goes earlier, or when the letter matches the letter that was spoken three times earlier. So in this case, try clicking or tapping on this video when you see the blue square appear in the same spot as it was three turns earlier, or when you hear the same letter said as it was three turns earlier. Ready?
A C T V B T J.
You should have paused this video twice, and that's a tiny taste of what the NBAC is like. It was immediately obvious to me that I'm not a supertasker, because my brain can't even. And supertasking aside, lots of studies have found evidence that groups of people can multitask. In one, elderly adults were asked to cycle on a stationary bike while completing increasingly difficult tasks, like repeating a list of numbers in reverse order. Completing those cognitive tasks actually resulted in the participants cycling faster than when they weren't multitasking. Another study found when participants were given two letter-matching tasks at the same time, each hemisphere of the medial frontal cortex processed one of those tasks independently of the other. But when a third task was added, participants behaved almost as if they forgot one of the three tasks, and they performed much worse overall. The thing is, we can't definitively say that people can or can't multitask. Multitasking is an ability. There's a spectrum from people who are better at single tasks, to task switchers, to great supertaskers. If you try and do multiple challenging things all at once, yes, you'll probably do worse in all of them. But if you focus on learning a process inside and out, you could probably do it while you do something else. Remember David Babcock? He took up running and knitting at about the same time, so he had lots of practice doing them and doing them together. So, how many things can you do at once? And one more thing, guys, I have an announcement which is in the form of a person. This is Shinny, who's hosting Crash Course Physics. What can we look forward to in Crash Course Physics?
So all the things that are particularly scary about physics, like vectors, calculus, integrals, remember those days?
Not really.
It was scary, but we make it really fun and we explain the concepts and it's fun. Check it out.
Awesome. I think I need to check it out and brush up on my physics, but I'll put a link down here. So go and check out Crash Course Physics and you can learn lots of awesome things with Shinny. Thanks for watching.